Go Bears!
Fight!
What's up? Chris is the man. Follow him on YouTube.
What's up?
Are you vlogging?
Okay, so now you wanna make love to me. Girl, if you don't get the fuck from me, I know you don't.
Alright guys, this is Edward. I just wanna say welcome to Chris's Day in the Life.
Stop. Girl, I'm sorry you not the one for me.
I'm dressed in all black like a funeral, and she in all white look like an angel. And I've been catching vibes all night. I could be the one who could ignite your life. And she said, by the way, what's your name? Come take a hit of this shit that I'm sipping, alright, my way. And she said, by the way, what's your name? Come take a hit of this shit that I'm sipping, alright, my way. Riding that way.
So you guys in the comment section have the absolute best ideas, right? Make a day in the life video and actually talk about your day. It's actually surprisingly boring and it's kind of lonely. And actually a lot of CS students at Berkeley at least just don't go to class. Like the campus is lively at the beginning of the semester and that's when everyone does their vlogs. But about 3 weeks in, people stop going to class and it's very obvious. The campus just dies. Classes are like barely half full. And that's not because people are lazy, but people figure out that going to class isn't always that effective because all the lectures are webcasted. So you can just watch a video at like 1.5 or 2x speed, and the audio comes directly from the professor's mic and into your earphones. If you go in person, the professor talks at the speed of a tractor. The reverb from the speakers is just so bad because the room sounds like you're in a gas station bathroom, and it's just really hard to pay attention because they just ramble on for like 90 minutes straight, and then you lose another 30 minutes just walking to and from class. But I still try to go to class when I can because I think it is good to have a routine and do things that make you feel productive. There is value in that, but a lot of college students will take this way too far because actually how well you do in your classes is usually a direct correlation with your total number of minutes you're like focused staring at a screen. But that doesn't really get good watch time. You can't make a Facebook post about that. So a lot of students get the impression that you should just fill up your whole schedule and try to look like John Fish. And a lot of things that people do for productivity don't actually give you better grades. They don't make your life that much better. So some of the most productive people I know here at Berkeley will find the things that actually count as productive and matter, and they'll find shortcuts to them. For example, wearing a very simple, straightforward wardrobe, eating fewer meals or just cooking meals in bulk to save time, and then reading nonfiction books. Why would you sit down and read for hours at a time when instead you can check out today's sponsor, Blinkist? Blinkist is an app that condenses nonfiction books into just 15 minutes, and that's not very long. I've learned so much from books about personal finance, lifestyle design, career development, and more, and Blinkist is a good resource for fitting these things into your daily life. There are some classics that you really should have read by now because everyone talks about them, but you really just need the key ideas. Awaken the Giant Within, 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, Rich Dad Poor Dad, Outliers. I've read the full versions of all of these books, and I can confirm that the Blinkist versions do them justice. So the app itself is really cool. Let me show you guys, it'll be really quick. I like the way they organize their categories and recommendations. You just find a book that looks interesting, you hit the plus sign, and boom, it's saved to your library. It's split up into nice little sections called blinks, so you can listen to one, read another one at your own pace, and the whole thing is just 15 minutes. So in the time it takes me to clean up my room, do laundry, walk to class, I can get through a whole book, fast track my education, and that's pretty cool. If you're interested, go check them out at the link in the description. I'm hooking you guys up with 1 week completely free and then 25% off the full membership if you want it. So I gotta go to campus now because YouTube is motivating me to go to class. I will talk to you guys in a bit.
Hey. Making my way downtown, walking.
walking fast, faces pass and I'm homebound. Staring blankly ahead, just making my way through the crowd.
The dash a digi, the schedule busy, my head in a hoodie, my shorty a goodie, my cousins are crazy, my cousins like Boogie. Life is amazing, it is what it should be. Been here for 10, but I feel like a rookie. I tell her, look up, cause it's snowing.
Filming like, rolling. Yeah, we're just like messing around right now. Yeah.
Dude, I was the one on your YouTube video and I asked you about 61 beats.
Oh.
Yeah, and you just wanted to be. Thank
yeah,
you.
No problem.
Got a Mercedes. Your money records, the army, the navy. They ran me 10,000, I threw it like Brady. The foreign is yellow like Tracy and Katie. I trust in my niggas, they never betray me. Met all these niggas, they sweeter than Sadie. When I started out, I just took
what you said, by the way. What's your name? Come take a hit of this shit that I'm sipping, alright, my way. And she said, by the way, what's your name? Come take a hit of this shit that I'm sipping, alright, my way. Riding that way.
Pappies still used to be $5.
Why, what?
Like, you know the Monday Madness for Pappies?
Yeah.
So you see, it was $5 for like 3 years, but now it's $8. Like, we're trying to find a new deal.
Really doing us dirty here. Walk us through your day.
Today, I woke up at 8:45 because of construction next to my apartment. And then I stayed at home, I played League of Legends for 3 hours, and then I made a pizza.
Was it fire?
It was pretty good, but we were using like pink Himalayan salt right now. It's a normal salt and tastes kind of weird. After that, went to Starbucks, then studied. I had class for 1 hour today, 3 to 4, and that's about it. And now I'm probably doing more Lico.
I mean,
we riding the waves, riding the waves.
I don't like it that much.
Oh yeah. It wasn't even a fade. That was just like, they just took everything off.
Straight up like skin faded my entire like.
Excuse me. What? Yes, I am. Hello.
Oh, hello.
What's up?
Are you filming?
So. I'm arguing today, well, what I'm proposing today, that there are certain organs.
Bishop, tripping on beaches with beautiful women. I feel ignited, I fight for my life.
What's poppin'? So, I just came from my gender and women's studies class, and that's the most Berkeley sounding class on the planet, but I actually like it. All we really did in class is just watch films, and there's only like 2 assignments and a final the entire semester, but watch me still fail it. So after class, I went to Walgreens and got a sandwich. It is turkey cranberry multigrain, and then I have a study session and then a meeting later. I'm probably gonna just leave early from both. And then later tonight, I might get dessert with Meredith Mao, who actually is another YouTuber. She has a car here in Berkeley, so that's amazing. I'm gonna try to study. I'll talk to you guys later. So first of all, yes, I do have a standing desk, and then I'm only taking 1 computer science class, and there's actually no code in it. It's called CS174, and it's basically about probabilistic algorithms. So it's a proof-based class, and it's just all theoretical. So the first homework assignment just got released. So this assignment is basically a review of discrete probability, which should be straightforward because I've like done it before, but I'm pretty garbage at it, so I'm gonna have to review a bit. One of the first questions is, you flip a coin 10 times, what is the probability that you get at least 4 consecutive heads? We have to give the specific probability and then a convincing explanation for why it's so. And then some later questions ask stuff about picking random binary vectors to test the equivalence of matrices, min-cut algorithms with weighted edges, and then some scenario where like 2 people have children. If you're watching this right now and you're actually in this class and you're good at this stuff, first of all, please hit the like button, and then let's be friends. I'll have a crack at this myself. We'll see how it goes.
She don't play, and she my type. She got brains, and them tots out. She that lady, she gon' dance. Ain't gon' touch her phone. She gon' let it smoke. She don't play, and she my type. She got brains, and them tots out. She that lady, she gon' dance. Ain't gon' touch her phone. She gon' let it smoke. Don't hide, don't move. Not just they friends. But with my dudes, cause you look so fly, and you look so cute. K
Can I make you mine? What you wanna do?
Hello. What's up?
Amazing. Oh my god, I'm on your block!
I just went to a club meeting. I used to be in the club, I just wanted to say hi to people, but I left after 5 minutes because I'm meeting up with Meredith. She has a YouTube channel, check it out, and we're getting dessert.
It's like what is it? Really bomb Asian dessert.
Is there food nearby?
Near it? Wait, we can go to In-N-Out. Do you like In-N-Out? She my type, she got brains, and I'm top tied, she that lady, and she gon' dance. Hey, Brian, let's bring your bag. She called me this moment.
Yeah.
Oh, it's a wait. Why is oh that's that side? Okay.
Oh my God, Chris! Please don't say shit like that to me.
Just go home.
Me out.
Okay.
Also, have you had Shake Shack before?
I've had Shake Shack, yeah.
Shake Shack or In-N-Out?
The thing is that like you can't compare In-N-Out
yes,
and Shake
you
Shack.
Can.
No, because they're different price ranges. Shake Shack is like $9. In-N-Out isn't the same price range as like Wendy's and Carl's Jr., right? In which case it blows them out of the water. But Shake Shack, you should compare it to like Super Duper and The Habit.
Okay.
That's more fair.
Spending all my life so long waiting for you to call me. You're the only one I want by my side when I fall asleep. Tell me what I'm waiting for. Tell me what I'm waiting for. No, I'm sorry, but we need each other. I move my ways on my own, don't need nobody, yo. Change your mind when I change my life, better start believing in myself. And we all now looking for God, so we never see it in ourselves. Shit divine and adventure and movie style. It's hard to tell what a prayer compels. You can find me dancing in the middle, playing drums, trying to find a way to make a
change. So everyone's gonna say, this was a really chill day. Why are you making Berkeley CS look super easy? We know it isn't. Three things, actually. One is that if you actually look at the CS requirements, you actually don't need that many classes. The second thing is that I'm trying to protect my motivation, because the college application process trains people to talk about your hopes and dreams, tell everyone how hard you work, but doing this never actually helps you more than not doing that. You just set aggressive expectations, you give yourself less freedom, and then become more susceptible to burnout, and this is actually the most common way that a lot of students will sabotage their own hopes and dreams. The third thing is that in about a week, I'm actually leaving Berkeley to start a full-time internship at Google, and I gotta try to pass my classes while missing 12 weeks of school. And I know what you're thinking. That's kinda stupid. You are actually going to die. And you are right. But you are going to help me through this by very supportively smashing the like button. No, but actually, the YouTube algorithm really likes that. It helps more people see my content. So if you enjoy this video, I would really appreciate it if you could just drop a like, comment anything, especially if you know me in person, like just say hi. Talking to a camera is really lonely. Thank you so much for watching. I'm gonna go try to study, but I also might not. See you in the next video.